So hello and good morning, everyone. We're really pleased to have all of you here today. I'm State Representative Dianne Herrin in the Greater Westchester area, and welcome to our virtual Senior Expo. Today we have three terrific panelists, which we will introduce right before they're ready to speak. And they're going to share with all of us some of the great services that we have available to our seniors here in this district. I would like to mention that this is being recorded and also pushed out live on social media, just so everyone is aware. And we will be taking questions and answers toward the end of all three presentations. If, however, a question arises and you'd like to get it down on record, you can put it in the chat and we will track everything and make sure that your questions are brought up and answered. So before we begin, I'd like to just introduce to you my dream team, I call them, and I mean that very sincerely. I have an incredible staff that is here to serve you. And our goal is to provide the best constituent services that we can. And I'm proud to say that I believe we do. So first, we have Emily Pisano. She's my district office director. Say hi, Emily. We have Kevin Carson, who is my constituent services director. I think he might be on the phone helping a constituent at the moment, but he'll be in momentarily. We have the other Kevin, Kevin Burke, who's a constituent services advisor, and he focuses on all of our communications and does a tremendous job. And we have Bria Hughes, who's also constituent services advisor, and she helps put together all of our outreach programs, including this virtual Senior Expo today. And also, Bria speaks Spanish and is very helpful when we have Spanish-speaking constituents in need. So thank you, Bria. So we will get started. The way our agenda will proceed today is we will have each of our guest panelists give a brief presentation on the services that they can provide you. And then Emily, our district office director, will give some information about other programs and fun activities that we have planned in the district throughout the coming months. And Kevin Carson, our constituent services director, will give information about PennDOT and discounts that you can receive for transportation. And Bria will then close out with information about the property tax and rent rebate that is available. And then we'll get into our Q&A and we'll have some closing remarks and we'll be done. So again, thank you all so much for being here. And we're going to get started with our first panelist. Our first panelist is Victoria Long with the Senior Law Center. And Victoria, she joined the Senior Law Center staff in 2019. And prior to that, she was with Benefilly, and she was instrumental in helping people in the city of Philadelphia access public benefit programs. She describes the highlight of her work at the Senior Law Center as being her ability to help seniors feel seen and heard in a society that often ignores their issues. She prides herself on being able to make someone feel validated and seen. And we're so happy to have Victoria here today. So welcome, Victoria. And we look forward to your comments. So you can proceed. Thank you.
Hi, yes. So my name is Victoria Long, and I am the Elder Victim Legal Advocate for the Senior Law Center Chester County branch. And so basically, if you have an issue, a legal issue in Chester County, and you're over the age of 60, you're going to call me and I will direct you to the person that can help very efficiently. You'll never know how quickly I can do it. So I wanted to give everyone a brief overview of Senior Law Center services. We are new to the Chester County area. Newer. 2 years ago, we opened our office out here in Westchester. We have been in Philadelphia for over 43 years. So I'm originally from Philadelphia. I was a volunteer at Senior Law Center while I was in college. And when I told them, hey, listen, I can't volunteer any longer. I'm moving to Chester County for my husband's work. They said, well, guess what? We actually are opening an office out there. Would you like to take the role of advocate for the seniors out there? And I absolutely was like, you know, sometimes the universe just works things out for you. And it was an amazing opportunity to move out here and be of service to a new community of seniors. So with that being said, we have multiple programs. I work in the Financial Exploitation and Elder Abuse Department. So if you are a senior that is a victim of financial exploitation, like power of attorney abuse, contractor fraud, or one of those phone scams or text message scams, or abuse, which is, you know, neglect, physical abuse, or emotional abuse, I would be the advocate you'd be working with. And I have an attorney that works closely with me in Chester County named Susan Nolan. So we're the Chester County team for abuse and exploitation. That being said, our office based out of Philadelphia has over 20 plus staff attorneys and other legal advocates. So we provide a holistic view of services. We have landlord-tenant. We have grandparents raising grandchildren, which is a new program that we recently got funded, which helps seniors who are dealing with custody issues of their grandchildren because of the opioid epidemic. We've seen a huge influx of grandparents needing assistance with raising their grandchildren because the parents are sick and suffering and unable to handle that responsibility right now. So we've created a whole program to help assist them with that. We have a program that helps keep seniors in their home, the Foreclosure Avoidance Project. So basically, you know, as vague as I can be about it, if you have a legal issue and you are a Pennsylvania resident over the age of 60, you can call me and I will be able to set you up with free legal services over the phone. So what that normally looks like is a senior will call, they'll say, you know, my landlord is, you know, threatening to turn off my water and electric and they're saying they're going to evict me. I don't know what to do. So they call me. I'll do a very short intake. It usually takes about 15 minutes on the phone just to get some basic information down. And then I will schedule them to talk to an attorney, usually within the week. You know, 5 days is usually the maximum. We have a lot of attorneys. So I'll schedule them to talk to an attorney free of charge. You can take 15 minutes to get your questions out. You can take 2 hours to come up with a full game plan. Our attorneys will provide resources, referrals. And in certain cases, if we have the funding, so I can't make any promises on this, you know, overview, we can provide representation. So going to court, filing petitions, all of that kind of thing. But it really is based on a case-to-case basis. So that's a general overview of how Senior Law Center works. I did want to utilize the rest of my time to quickly go over the signs of elder abuse, because that is one of the biggest issues we're seeing across the county, is elder abuse. Specifically financial exploitation by family members. And so when we hear in the news about financial exploitation, it's always about the phone scams and the sheriff scam and the IRS calling and the person pretending to be Social Security. And that is absolutely a problem. That is a big issue. We all know it. However, the bigger percentage of exploitation against seniors is actually by what we call community members. So friends, family, neighbors, loved ones, people they know are more likely to defraud and exploit a senior than the phone scam caller. So I like to talk about that because it's not often seen in the news about, you know, the warning signs, what to look for. So again, it was really hard last year because of pandemic to get eyes on the situation, if you will, because the biggest issue with exploitation of seniors is isolation. When no one's around to see them, when they're not going to church, when they're not going to their community centers, you know, no one has eyes on them, so we can't monitor what our friends and loved ones are doing. And so the pandemic really made it hard to find out if seniors were being abused and have it reported if they weren't willing to report it themselves. So the quick signs of elder abuse would be if you see a senior who is wearing clothing that isn't weather appropriate. So summertime clothes in the winter, wintertime clothes in the summer. This can be a sign that they're not taking their medication, that their medication is not being provided for them. This could be a sign that there's no running water or electric to do their laundry. We just want to make sure we're looking at things and not assuming the worst, but also being a little critical. Like, why is Mary dressed like that in the middle of summertime? That doesn't make much sense. Maybe I should reach out to her daughter or her friends or see what's going on, because it doesn't seem normal.
Victoria, you're muted. We can't hear you.
I don't know how that happened.
So I don't either. It just happened suddenly. We missed like the last four or five sentences.
Okay. So what we would say is that, you know, be on the lookout for new friends. So whether that's, you know, a new loved one or a new person they met on the internet from internet dating, you know, just being a little bit critical, asking some questions, asking some background questions, just because we want to make sure that people that are being involved in a senior's life have their best intentions at heart. And again, lack of adequate facilities. If you are talking to a senior that doesn't have running water or electric, or one of their utilities is off, please reach out to us, reach out to State Rep's office, because that is a real sign that something's wrong. We know that most seniors are getting at least Social Security, that we know there's at least some money coming in, and there are programs that help keep the utilities on. So there's no reason that they shouldn't have that. And if they don't, it could be a sign that their power of attorney is taking their funds inappropriately, or that someone that's in the house is exploiting them in some way. So we just want to be very aware of what abuse can look like, because there's so many different varieties of it. And if you are thinking that there might be abuse, you can, of course, call me. And I am able to reach out to the senior or the Department of Aging and get some resources involved to see if we can help. But I think that's my time. But again, if you have any questions at the end of this, please reach out. If I'm unable to answer them because they're legal questions, I'm not an attorney, so I can't answer legal questions. You can, of course, call me. I will schedule you to talk to an attorney free of charge, and we will get your legal questions answered. Okay. Thank you.
Thank you so much, Victoria. I was, prior to becoming state rep, I was mayor of Westchester. And when I was mayor, you did come into the Westchester community and open up an office. And I was so very grateful, because this issue of exploitation of our seniors, particularly, as you mentioned, financial exploitation, is just so important. And we are really grateful to have you here to be a free resource to our seniors. So thank you so much. So our next presenter is Rochelle Culbreth. And Rochelle is manager of legislative affairs with SEPTA. She is former president of the Norristown Municipal Council and has received awards from multiple organizations, including the Elks Lodge of Norristown, the Norristown Alliance of Black Educators, the Women of Vision Award given by Montgomery County, and the NAACP Community Service Award. So in addition for her great work with SEPTA, Rochelle is best known for her creation of the Save Our Hospital campaign, which fought to keep Montgomery Hospital open in Norristown back in 2005. So Rochelle is here today to talk with you about the services offered by SEPTA, such as the senior pass and reduced fares and other services. So thank you for being here, and take it away, Rochelle.
Hi, good morning, everyone. Hello, Representative Herrin. My name is Rochelle Culbreth. I'm the manager of legislative affairs here at SEPTA, the sixth largest transit agency in the United States. It's my privilege to be here. I appreciate the opportunity to speak with you about SEPTA Senior Services. And I also wanted to shout out to your illustrious staff, because they are amazing. I got to come out and meet you guys a couple of weeks ago, and I really enjoyed meeting every one of you, and I look forward to working with you with your constituent services as well as your seniors. So I've been here at SEPTA for quite a long time now. It's almost 15 years, and I wanted to make sure that I share with you and your seniors what services are available at SEPTA. Now that the seniors are, most of the seniors and most of us are vaccinated, we're getting back out there start to see the world open again. And we have so much exciting things going on, not only downtown here, but also in King of Prussia. There's tons of pop-ups that are happening. So I wanted to make sure that the seniors can have access to that. So there's a way that seniors can get their senior ride free card. Seniors ride free on SEPTA. Anybody 65 or older rides free on SEPTA. In order to get your senior ride free card, you can get it two different ways. One, you can go to your state representative's office or your state senator's office. Or you can come downtown to 1234 Market Street, but you have to make an appointment if you're going to come downtown. That's the great part of having access to get your senior ride free card in your local legislative district office. The senior cards look like that. You can see it behind my head. They're a green card that gets mailed to you in the mail after you go to your legislative office and have your photo taken. That card allows you to ride free on any bus, train, subway, trolley, or regional rail if you are a senior 65 or older. That card has an expiration date that has been extended to 2022, and you can use that card on the flash, which takes you to all the local exhibits downtown once you get downtown, or you can also ride free on our access to the MAN, so the MAN Center loop. I spoke about a couple of the pop-ups at King of Prussia, so we have access to get to King of Prussia from our bus service. And I'm going to send some more schedules to Representative Herrin's office. But we are encouraging seniors to get your senior ride free card. Take a trip downtown to the visitor center, to the museums. There's tons of new restaurants that have opened up since the pandemic. And we're just hoping that they get out more.
Terrific. I would like to ask my Constituent Services Director Kevin Carson to just very briefly explain the SEPTA Pass service that we can provide right here in our office, if you wouldn't mind.
Thank you, Representative. So as Rochelle indicated, you can apply for your SEPTA Senior Card in our district office. All that you need to provide is a form of ID that shows proof of age that you're over 65, and we will take all the information and take your photo here in the office. And once that application is processed on SEPTA servers, that will be mailed out to you within a few weeks. And that's the service we provide here in our Westchester office.
Thank you, Kevin. This is actually a very popular service, so we welcome you to come in. Our address is 21 West Washington Street on the first floor, Suite A, right in the borough of Westchester. And we have free parking right out front. So we welcome you if you want to come in and get your pass. So thank you so much, Rochelle. We really greatly appreciate your being here and explaining to us these great services that you provide. And we appreciate the work you do for our seniors. Thank you.
Thank you, Greg.
So we have our third guest panelist. I would like to introduce Cheryl Bruck, who is the care manager with the Chester County Department of Aging Services. Cheryl is an experienced social worker in both the civic and social organization industries, and she is a professional in community and social services. She has a background in healthcare management and also education. And one great thing I just learned about Cheryl is that she does pet assisted therapy, which I think is awesome. So Cheryl's going to talk about the services that the Chester County Department of Aging Services provides. So Cheryl, thank you for being here. I think you're muted, though. We can't hear you. Can sort of hear you, but
let me do this.
There we go. Whoop, now you're muted again. Hold on, you're muted again. I can.
How's that?
That's much better.
I think the headphones really did me in.
Yeah.
Well, anyway, thank you all for having me today. I like to think that we do a really phenomenal job of taking care of the needs of over 60 population in Chester County. We are sort of a jack of all trades, I would say. Basically, we do four major things, and I will break them down after I just cover them. We do information and assistance. We do assessments, care management, and protective services. And protective services is, it taps into what Vicki was talking about, and I'll go into more detail. So as far as information and assistance is concerned, we are inundated with phone calls, walk-ins, and with every single question you can imagine, from affordable dental care to the LIHEAP program, which helps pay for heat and utilities. We help people with emergency funds, housing. We just are sort of a resource center for the over 60 seniors in Chester County. Then past that level, we'll sort of refer to either, we'll keep them in-house for services or refer them out for services. And when we feel that it's necessary, we do assessments. So we go out and do all the assessments in the community to see if people are at the nursing facility level, at the skilled level, or if they're still at the independent level, because most people want to remain in their homes. And with those assessments, those assessors will refer for care management a lot of times. And our care management team is phenomenal. We do home visits, telephone calls, and we help people get aids in the home, personal care aids for bathing, dressing, grooming, laundry, meals, shopping, transportation. We can get people alarm necklaces, the life alert necklaces. We help people get Meals on Wheels. And we also deliver the caregiver support program, where there's some reimbursement for caregivers who either need some respite or are really spending a lot of money buying products for their loved ones and their seniors. So that is our care management team. And then on top of that, we are responsible for the protection of the seniors in our community. So we do all the investigations for abuse. And a lot of that is sort of what Vicki talked about. There's a lot of exploitation and financial abuse, but there's also physical abuse and emotional abuse. And so we go out and we do all of those investigations for those folks who are vulnerable and who, you know, may not have informal supports, or they have a cognitive impairment and they really can't advocate for themselves. But basically, we are sort of the resource hub in our county, and we really help people stay independent in their homes, because that is what most seniors want to do. There are basically two funding streams for staying in the home. One is a Medicaid funded program that's called the waiver, and it's a very meaty program, and we help people get onto the waiver who are eligible, and there are income requirements for that. You have to have less than $2,382 a month coming in, which is not hard to meet, because a lot of people are living on Social Security alone, and it's very difficult. But if you have less than $8,000 in assets as well, we can get you aid care in the home and keep you out of a nursing facility, which is really special and really fantastic. For the people that don't meet that criterion, we deliver this other program called Options, and that's what we do a lot of care management for. And that particular program is a cost share. It's a sliding scale. But many seniors are at the 0% or at a very low percent, which just means that the aid care that's normally very expensive hourly, it might be normally $25 an hour if you have to pay out of pocket, we get a discounted rate, which is $19.92 per hour. And then our seniors might only pay nothing or a portion of that rate to get aid care in the home and get some help with reducing the risk of falls, staying independent. And that's just a really nice service. And with that, you get care management. So we're sort of checking in on you and making sure you're safe. And then the other thing that I didn't mention that's attached to us is the Apprise folks. And the Apprise is their insurance specialists in our county who answer all calls related to Medicare, as confusing as it is, because believe me, it is. They're like encyclopedias of insurance and Medicare, and it's free. It's a free service. And so we help people, you know, we refer to people to Apprise as well. So is there, I don't know if there's, I'm trying to think anything that I didn't go over. So really it's just information and assistance, which could be a multitude of things, could be anything related to the needs of the over 60 population, those assessments for nursing facilities and staying independent in the home, the care management piece, which is just keeping people independent in their home, and then the protective services, which is all the dirty work and the nitty gritty and the keeping people safe in our community. So that's it.
So, well, that is a tremendous amount of services that you provide. And I believe that we're very fortunate here in Chester County to have so many services that are readily accessible and free of charge and available to our seniors. So thank you so much. We want to be sure everyone is aware. We put the phone number for Chester County Aging Services and the Senior Law Center into the chat for you. And we'll also be putting my office phone number and address and contact information email in there. If you have any questions at all, you need to contact Victoria or Cheryl, and you're not sure how, we will certainly help all of you with that. So before we get to the Q&A, we'd like to proceed with Emily Pisano, our district office director, and she's going to give us all a brief overview of some other programs and activities for seniors. Emily?
Thank you, Rep. Herrin. Hi, everyone. My name is Emily, and as Representative Herrin mentioned, I would like to share with you some things you can do throughout the district this summer and the coming months now that the COVID restrictions have been lifted and so many of us are vaccinated. For residents of PA who have lived in the state for at least 1 year and are at least 60 years of age, have the opportunity to enroll in classes at Westchester University completely tuition-free. Those interested can enroll as either a degree or non-degree student and take classes for credit if they wish. Enrollment in classes is offered on a space available basis, but feel free to sign up with your friends. This is a great way to learn a new language, brush up on your math skills, or dive into a subject that has always been of interest to you. And if you're interested, for additional information, I will add the phone number for the university's registrar's office, and they will be able to assist you in enrolling or with any questions that you have. So I'll put that in the chat for you. Next, the Pennsylvania Historical and Museum Commission offers reduced rates at many of their state-owned historic sites and museums for any PA resident 60 or older. These sites are located both in and around Chester County, and they make for a fun road trip over the summer. I will add links in the chat as well so you can see a map of exact locations and learn more about the historical sites. And then our office is very excited because later this summer and into early fall, we will be offering a program we're calling Hikes with Herrin, and we'll be inviting the public to join us in parks throughout the district for hikes with Representative Herrin. Each one will have a different theme. So we'll be talking about preservation of open space, invasive species, and we will also have one where you can bring your dog, and that will be a really fun thing. So keep an eye out. We will have additional info for you. And for anyone, I know there's a few of you that are joining us over the phone and probably can't see the chat. So we will be sharing all of this information and contact info with everyone who's here after the meeting is over today. And now I'm going to turn it over to our Constituent Services Director, Kevin Carson, who will share with you how to get a discount on your car registration to PennDOT.
Yeah, thank you, Emily. So if you are currently retired, you may be eligible for a discounted registration through PennDOT. That discounted registration rate is $10. To qualify, you do need to meet certain criteria. To start, you must receive Social Security or other types of pension payments. There are other forms of income that can be included as long as it does not exceed $19,200. That other income includes part-time work if you're retired from your principal occupation, any business or rental income, public assistance, and unemployment compensation. To have this discounted registration, your vehicle must be a car or truck, and the weight of that vehicle must not exceed 9,000 pounds. Only one vehicle per applicant can be registered for this retired status fee. Emily, as she indicated, will be also including the forms that do need to be completed to get this discounted registration. If for some reason you can't get access the forms on the computer, you can certainly visit our district office and you can complete them here. Our office hours are 8:30 to 4:30, Monday through Friday. And again, our address is 21 West Washington Street. Back to you, Emily.
That is it. So now I believe I will turn it back over to Representative Herrin.
Okay. Before we go to the Q&A, Bria Hughes, our constituent services advisor who focuses on outreach, is going to talk with you briefly about the property tax and rent rebate, which Bria and Kevin, they've actually been all around the district helping seniors fill out these forms, and we can absolutely help you fill them out so that you can get your rebates as well, should you qualify. So Bria's just going to explain that process to you right now. Thanks, Bria.
Thank you, Representative, and hello, everyone. The rent rebate program benefits eligible Pennsylvanians age 65 and older, widows and widowers age 50 and older, and people with disabilities age 18 and older. The income limit is $35,000 a year for homeowners and $15,000 a year for renters, and half of Social Security income is excluded from that amount. Spouses, personal representatives, or estates may also file rebate claims on behalf of claimants who lived at least one day in 2020 and meet all other eligibility criteria. The maximum standard rebate is $650, but supplemental rebates for qualifying homeowners can boost rebates to $975. Earlier this month, the Department of Revenue announced that the deadline for older and disabled Pennsylvanians to apply for rebates on rent and property taxes paid in 2020 has been extended from the original June 30th deadline to December 31st of this year. The program's claimants do have the option to file their rebate applications online by visiting mypath.pa.gov, and Emily will be placing that link in the chat as well. But our office is available to assist constituents with completing their applications. We are also able to assist Spanish-speaking constituents because, as Representative Herrin mentioned, yo hablo español y yo puedo ayudar a los hispanohablantes. And to schedule an appointment, please call our district office, and Emily will be putting that number in the chat as well. Most recently with this program and our community outreach efforts, our office was able to visit both the Denny Rayburn apartment community and the Church Street Towers apartment community to assist the residents with their applications. We have also assisted constituents here in the office, and in total thus far, we have assisted 40 constituents and saved them a combined projected $22,000. And as always, we look forward to seeing those numbers grow as we continue with this program for our constituents.
Excellent, excellent work, you guys.
Thank you.
I'm just so very proud of the services that we provide and really want everyone to know that this is the reason we exist. This is why we are here. We are here to serve you if you live in this district. And we don't care if you voted. We don't care if you voted for me. We are here for you. And we really encourage everyone to reach out to my office and to my team because we will help you in any way that we can. So at this point, I would love to open it up to see if anyone has any questions for our guest panelists or my staff or for me. We're happy to take any questions or comments that you might have. So Emily, can you tell folks how to do that?
Make sure you're unmuted, yes. And then at the top of your screen, if a few of you have questions at once, you can raise your hand. And that way we can be sure that we get to everybody. And we also had two questions that were submitted previous to the event. So I want to make sure we get those answered as well. The one is actually for Rochelle. And we were asked, if somebody has a senior key card that expires this December, how do they go about renewing it?
So you're asking if how do they renew their senior ride free card? Okay, so we have extended the expiration date for any expired senior ride free cards so if their card expired today, it wouldn't expire until the 17th of June, 2022. So they don't have to go immediately to renew their card. If they just want to renew it and they may be downtown, you can renew your card at 1234 Market Street. But as I said before, you have to actually have an appointment. And I can give your office the information for how they can make an appointment to do a renewal at 1234 Market.
Okay, but just to clarify, you've extended that for 1 year?
Correct.
Okay, so if your card expires the end of this month, you actually have a full year, that card will continue to work for a full year.
That is correct, okay. Representative.
Great. Can we renew those here in our office, Kevin? Do you know? No?
No, unfortunately, no. The only place okay. that we can do a renewal or expired card is downtown at 1234 Market. For now, that may change in the future.
Okay. Great. Thank you. Another question, Em?
Yes. Cheryl, I believe this one might go to you. So for a senior who is currently residing on their own in another state and receiving services, is there a way to seamlessly move them to Pennsylvania and without a disruption in service?
They really need to be living here and in the community, but the process is quick. So, the process is quick depending on the program that they're eligible for. The waiver process takes a little bit longer than the options process, so depending on where they are physically and financially, the road might be longer or shorter. So I would have to hear some details to tell you how quickly that can happen, but they do need to be in community because a lot can happen. If we went ahead and kind of secured services and then maybe a move didn't go through or whatever, we really need the person to be here. But the family, we would encourage the family to call us, get them set up in the system. We can take the referral so we know that they're coming. I would just encourage anybody to go ahead and reach out to us and at least start the communication process.
We will definitely make sure we share your contact information with the individual who asked that question.
That's good.
And then, so everyone sees it. If you're looking at your screen to raise your hand, it's a button at the top. It's a little smiley face with a hand over it. And if you rest your mouth over it, you can raise your hand. And that way we can make sure we see if you have a question.
So again, if you have any questions or comments, click the raise your hand button and we'll call on you. Okay, not seeing any. Just want to be sure. Give it another minute here.
Hello?
Okay.
I see a hand. I'm seeing a hand.
Are you?
Yeah, I see Zaya McLean. I see a hand up. I don't know if I'm the only one.
Yes, I see it too.
Okay.
Yeah, I have a question. You mentioned dental care.
Well, there's some affordable dentistry in the county. I know dentistry is a huge, huge issue because it's so expensive. So we can give some phone numbers for some programs and some places to go.
Thank you.
Yes, please call us.
Okay. Thank you.
We'll look forward to hearing from you.
We did put the number in the chat. Are you able to see that, Zaya?
Yeah.
Okay, good.
Is it the main number? They have the main number, 610-344-6350.
Yes, I wrote it down.
Perfect.
Yes. Anything else? I don't see any other hands up. Do you, Emily, see any hands up?
I do not.
Okay. Just checking the chat here. All right. Okay, well, I think we can wrap it up then. I just would love to thank again our three guest panelists for being here today and for all of the services you provide for our seniors. They're so important, and the fact that they're free of charge and so readily accessible is just terrific. Again, I think we're just very fortunate to be here in Chester County and to have all of these services. And we want to be sure our seniors are aware of them and know how to access them when they're needed. I'd like to thank my dream team. You guys are great. Please call us if you need anything at all, even if you're not sure if we can help, we can certainly point you in the right direction. We have a phone number, 610-696-4990, or you can email me at repherrin, H-E-R-R-I-N, at pahouse.net, and we will get back to you right away. I do want to close out and let you all know that I have started working with other members in the House of Representatives, including members across the aisle, and we have formed a little bipartisan group, and we've started to evaluate what we might be able to do as legislators to pass legislation to better protect seniors from financial exploitation and abuse. And so I will update you as we hopefully come up with some solutions and some ways that we can help you from the legislative perspective through this bipartisan group that we have formed. So I'm very excited about that. It's not often these days, unfortunately, that we have bipartisan cooperation like this. And it's something that is really important to me, that we work together on priorities that I know we all share. So we are working hard on that in Harrisburg. And my district office, again, is always working hard right here in the district to be of service to you. So unless there are any more questions, I don't see any hands up. I'd like to thank you all for being here today. And again, our panelists and my staff, you're all terrific. And look forward to continuing to work with everyone. So have a terrific day. Oh, do we have a question from William McCann?
Yes.
Okay, good. So, glad we saw that.
Bouncing back and forth between the audio on the phone and using my tablet. And I lost the meetings on the tablet. So I went to the phone, but I could not then ask a question. And so I had to get back on my tablet to do so.
Okay.
So I'm legally blind. And so my question goes to representative, the person from SEPTA. I do use Rover within Chester County, but I understand there's a service called CCT, which I believe is a SEPTA-based service. And I'm not sure if I can use it and when I can use it and where I can use it. Transportation is one of the number one issues for those of us in the low vision blind community. And so I'm really trying to figure that out for not only myself, but for the many people that I know who are in this situation. And so I hope to talk to the representative sometime about it, but also find out a little bit today about the CCT service and SEPTA. And is that something that is available to people in Chester County?
Yes. So hi, Mr. McCann. Two things. We have a reduced fare card for disabled riders. So that's people that still ride the regular fixed route service. You would ride at a discounted rate. And that card is a purple card that you can acquire at 1234 Market. And you just need proof of your disability. So that's someone that can ride a regular fixed route buses, trolleys, subways, or regional rail. It's riding at a half fare. But you were inquiring about CCT. CCT is our mirrored service for our regular fixed route buses. So everywhere you see us provide regular fixed route buses, you're going to, or service, you're going to see, you will have access to a CCT vehicle in that location. So what I'll do is I'll get your name, address, and information from the representative's office, and I'll make sure that I find out if we have service in the areas that you're trying to go to for CCT.
So, yes, what I'm thinking is I do use Rover within Chester County itself, and I know they pick me up at home. So that's a door-to-door service, and you can't beat that in many respects, though, of course, there are some issues. But I'm thinking, like, if I had to go into Philadelphia and go from one location to another, CCT could provide that service for me?
As long as there's a mirrored service of a regular fixed route bus where you're going. So I'll have to see where you're going and where your address is, and I'll be able to let you know if CCT can use that service.
Okay. And the other question I had to bounce off of that, you talked about the SEPTA key card, and I did get my card a couple years ago at the office in Westchester, at the representative's office in Westchester, representative committee's office at the time. And I think it expires in January of 2022.
Okay.
And so my question is, does that also the year extend then beyond that as well? Does that go to 2023?
No, we haven't extended it past 2022 yet, because we have a process in place for you to get your expired card renewed by that time.
Okay. And for someone like myself who has a disability, being able to go to the representative's office to take care of this is a significant issue. I mean, you know, that really makes it a lot easier for me than having to go into Philadelphia. Good. So I do hope that they're going to make that possible for renewals, as well as for those people just getting the card for the first time.
Agreed, Mr. McMahon. Yes, I'm working on it to make it the easiest way possible for seniors, as well as those that are disabled, to be able to renew their cards or get their expired cards renewed. I definitely feel the same way. We're going to make sure that it is the easiest way possible.
Well, thank you for doing that. And thank you, Representative Herrin, for having this meeting. I look forward to more meetings like this. Provides a lot of information, excellent information to the members of this community and to the community that I'm involved in as well. Thank you.
Thank you very much. And if you would like to schedule a follow-up call to talk about these issues with me, I would be more than happy to do so. So we'll reach out to you.
Terrific. Thank you.
Thank you for being here.
Yep.
Okay. Any more questions? Last call. Okay, I think we're good. Again, thank you so much, everyone. We will have more senior expos and more activities throughout the district. We have a newsletter, and we always announce these activities and events and expos in our newsletter. And so we will add you, if we have your email address, to the newsletter if you're not on it already. And we look forward to seeing you again soon. Thank you again, everyone, and have a great day.
Thank you all.